बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामुअलैकुम टू ऑल माई स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास फोर। हियर आई एम योर टीचर ऑफ साइंस सब्जेक्ट मिस ताबिर ज़हरा। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कवर अप अवर ऑल वर्कबुक एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ यूनिट नंबर टू। सो क्लास, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ओपन योर पेज नंबर 6 ऑफ योर वर्क बुक। द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज, हियर इज एन इलस्ट्रेशन ऑफ अ फूड चेन फ्रॉम प्रोड्यूसर टू टर्शरी कंज्यूमर एट द करेक्ट लेवल फॉर ईच एनिमल। दिस इज योर होमवर्क बिकॉज इट इज वेरी इजी एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस यूनिट एज यू हैव लर्नड इन योर प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट विच इज प्रोड्यूसर, विच इज primary consumer, which is secondary consumer and which is tertiary consumer. So you can easily do this exercise by yourself. Second question belongs to the topic of adaptation. Living things adapt to suit their environment. Below are 6 environments and 6 living things. Which living thing suits which environment? Connect them by drawing lines. Now the first figure is cactus. A cactus is a plant and a living thing, as all of you know very well. So the best environment for the cactus is desert environment, because cactus can live with very few water, or you can say that cactus can store water in its leaf, and cactus can get water from the depth of the earth because it has very deep and long roots. Now the second figure is of monkey. As all of you know that monkey has 2 legs and 2 arms. It has big arms, so it can climb from one tree to another tree. So the best environment for the monkey is rainforest environment. As you all of you know that forest have very tall trees, so monkey can climb or can swing from one tree to another tree for the search of food or for the survival. The third figure is of mountain goat. A mountain goat has a woolen skin, so it can live on very cold temperature. It is also used to live on very high places such as mountain. Because of its short and very strong legs, it can climb and jump from one mountain to another surface. And also, it has very very good grip because of its hooves. So it can live in mountain environment where the surface is very rough and very high. Now the fourth example, the fourth figure is of alligator. Alligator is used to live in river environment. It is very easy example. Now the fifth one is a mole. As a mole is a type of a rat or a mouse, and all of you know that mouse lives deep under the ground. So a mole can also live deep under the ground because it is a type of a mouse. Now the sixth example is of polar bear. It is also a very easy example. A polar bear has very very thick skin or very thick fur, so it can live in very cold temperature or it can live in Arctic environment. So these are the examples of some environments and some animals which they adapt due to their body structure and due to their skin or due to their arms or due to their legs or due to their grip. Now class, come on your page number 7 of your workbook. Here the question is, solve the crossword puzzle. सो हियर आर टू पार्ट्स ऑफ योर पजल. द फर्स्ट वन इज अक्रॉस एंड द सेकेंड इज डाउन. अक्रॉस मीनिंग फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट ऑफ योर पजल एंड डाउन मीनिंग फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम ऑफ योर पजल. सो यू हैव टू राइट करेक्ट आंसर इन दीज पजल्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन सेंटेंसेस. द फर्स्ट सेंटेंस इन अक्रॉस इज द डैश एनिमल reproduce the dash animals produce eggs. So the answer is female animal produce eggs. Now the next sentence is the form of reproduction that involves living thing reproducing by themselves. As I was told in your previous lecture that there are two types of reproduction. The first one is sexual reproduction and the second one is asexual reproduction. As all of you know very well that in asexual reproduction, living thing reproduce a new living thing by themselves by breaking themselves into two pieces, and then these two pieces grow up naturally individually. So the answer is asexual reproduction. Now the first sentence of down is to bring an egg to life. So I was told in the topic of reproduction is that the process of bringing new life in the world is called fertilization. So the answer in this puzzle is fertilize. Now the second sentence in down part is a type of animal that gives birth to young live young. So the type of that animal is called mammals, because I was told in our that mammals give birth to young animal, and the other type is that animal that hatches out from the egg. Now the third sentence is it hatches to release a baby animal. So the answer is egg hatches to release a baby animal. The question number 2 is word search. Find the words listed below in the word search. So class, it is very easy exercise and it is also your homework. You have to do it by yourself. So in this exercise you will circle out the complete word which are given below, just as I have done tertiary. Same in this manner, you have to circle the correct spelling of the words which are given below. Now class, come on your page number 8. Here the question is circle the correct answer. The first part is water is made from number 1 oxygen and hydrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide, hydrogen and carbon dioxide, none of the above. So according to our previous lecture, I was told you that water is made from oxygen and hydrogen. In water, two part is of hydrogen and one part is of oxygen. The second part is animals that get energy from animals that eat plants are known as producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer. So I was told in our first lecture that plants take energy directly from the sun. So plants are called producer, and that animals which eat plant is called primary producer, primary consumer, and the animals who eat primary consumer is called secondary consumer. So the answer is secondary consumer. Now the third part is which gas do plant absorb? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen and nitrogen. So the answer is carbon dioxide, because plants uses carbon dioxide in the process of photosynthesis to make their food. Now the part number 4 is, which feature help a polar bear to survive in a cold climate? Long ear, thick fur, sharp eyes, different colored coat. So the answer is thick fur. Because of its thick fur or its thick skin, it can survive in very cold environment or Arctic environment. The fifth part is, which of the following is true about animals in movement? Animals move to find food and water. Animal moves to find shelter. Animal move to escape predators. All of the above. So the answer is all of the above, because I was told you in our previous lecture that these are all reasons due to which animal moves from place to place. Now the part number 6 is, the process by which animals reproduce by themselves is called fertilization, asexual reproduction, hatching and production. So its answer is very easy and you will do it by yourself. And its answer is also present in crossword puzzle also. Now question number 2 is, animals in your environment. Can you think of some animals that live in the wild near your home? They could be bird or insect or large animal or even a stray. Go outside and try to see one. Watch what it does. Note what it looks like. What are its most obvious features? Then draw this animal. Write some notes in explaining how its features work within environment. Your teacher can help you if you are unsure what to write. So here I am giving you the example of a domestic cat. So you have to write these features in your book and you will draw a picture of a cat. And also you have to write another example by yourself. So here are some features that enables a domestic cat to live in our environment. The first feature is, a cat has a flexible body to move in our house and to enter from very small spaces of doors. The second feature is, it has a large flexible tail which helps to balance a cat at very high buildings. Cats has shiny eyes which helps it to move at night and to catch prey. Cat has high sense of smelling and hearing which helps it to search prey and food from garbage. Cat has a friendly behavior with humans. So these are the prominent features of a domestic cat. And due to these features, it can live in our houses, it can live in big cities, it can live in high buildings, and it can search its food from any type of the waste or garbage or from any place. So class, here we are completing our unit number 2. We have covered all topics of this lesson. I hope you will understand all these topics and you will do your homework on time. If you have any type of confusion regarding to these topics, you can freely ask to me. So class, before starting our next unit, that is unit number 5, make sure that your work of this unit should be completed properly without any complication. So inshallah, in our